Hey guys, I'm Natasha and today we are going to discuss about vectors and scalar and their types. So let's start. First of all, I will tell you that what is a scalar quantity. Okay, so let me write here on the board. Scalar quantity has magnitude but no direction. Got it? Scalar quantity has only magnitude but not any specified direction. So but no specified direction. Okay, so this means that scalar quantity only has magnitude but not any specified direction. Means that scalar quantity, and now I'm giving you an example. So let's take an example. So the example is time is equals to 10 seconds. Okay. So in this example, we are getting only magnitude, but we are not getting any specified direction. So this example will be scalar quantity. Okay. And now let's take another example of vector quantity so that you can understand clearly. First of all, let me tell you that what is a vector quantity. Actually, vector quantity has magnitude plus specified direction. Means that what is the vector? Vector quantity has two factors. The first one is magnitude and the second one is direction. So now I'm giving you the example. So let's take example that distance from school to home is equal to 500 meter. Okay. So in this example, you're getting both magnitude and direction. So this example will be vector quantity. Why? Because it contains both magnitude and direction. What is vector quantity? Magnitude plus direction, means that the vector quantity has two factors, and the two factors are, first one is magnitude and second is direction. Okay, so now I hope that you will understand the two physical quantities, and the first one is scalar quantity and the second one is vector quantity. These are the two physical quantities. Now I'm going to tell you some examples of vector in nature. Okay, so some examples of vector in nature are velocity, momentum and force and etc. Okay. Now, and I'm also going to tell you the definition of these examples. So the first one I told you was velocity. So what is velocity? Speed with direction is called velocity. Second one was momentum. Okay. So a vector quantity which is the product of mass and velocity of an object or particle is called momentum. And the third one was force. Simply, force is a push or pull upon an object. Okay. And there are too many more examples, like electromagnetic fields, acceleration and etc. So now I'm going to tell you the characteristics of vectors so that the vector quantity means that the vector topic will be clear to all of you. Okay, so the first one characteristic of vector is these possesses both magnitude and direction. As I said before that vector quantity has magnitude plus direction. So okay, the first one is clear, and the second one is that they don't obey the ordinary laws of algebra. Actually, the vector quantity actually don't follow or obey the ordinary laws of algebra. They actually really don't follow. And the third one characteristic is that they change if either or magnitude or direction or both change. Means that in vector quantity, magnitude or direction can be changed or both can change. Okay. And the fourth one is this is the main characteristic of vector. The fourth one is that these vectors, means that the vector is represented by letters having arrows over them. Like that. A, and this is the symbol of vector. So this one is called A vector or vector A. But the vector A is more comfortable than A vector. So vector A. Now I'm going to tell you that, I'm going to tell you about some types, okay, of vectors. So the first one is null vector. What is a null vector? Okay, so let me rub this. Okay, so what is a null vector? Null vector. First of all, let me tell you that null vector is also known as zero vector. Let me write it. Zero vector. Okay. So null vector means that why the null vectors are called zero vector? Why they are called zero vectors? Because definition of null vector is that a null vector is a vector having magnitude equal to zero. Means that the null vector's magnitude always be zero or its magnitude equal to zero. So that's why they are called zero vector. and zero vector symbol is like that. Like that, it can be called O vector or zero vector. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you that how we can represent the magnitude or direction of zero vector. Okay, so I'm going to give an example. So let me give you an example how to represent the magnitude of vector A. Let's take vector A example. Okay, so to represent the magnitude of vector A, we can represent the magnitude of vector A through mod A. This is the symbol of mod. Okay, so means that we can represent the magnitude of vector A is equal through mod A. Okay, and if we have to represent the direction of vector A, then what will we do? Okay, so if means that we can represent the direction of vector A through a hat. So the symbol of a hat is this, like that. Okay, a hat. Okay, so next one is that if the mod a is equals to zero vector or O vector, zero vector or O vector, and the a hat is equals to arbitrary. What is arbitrary? What is the meaning of arbitrary? Arbitrary means not certain. And I'm going to tell you the definition of null vector by using the arbitrary word. So the definition of null vector is a vector having magnitude equals to zero and an arbitrary direction is called null vector. Okay, so let me write it there. Arbitrary. So this is it. This is the spelling of arbitrary. So this means that mod A is equals to vector zero vector and a hat is equals to arbitrary. Means that as I have seen that vector, if we have to represent the magnitude of vector A, then the mod A will be equal to the magnitude of vector A, and we can represent the direction of vector A through a hat. This one is the symbol of a hat. Okay, so the mod A is equals to be zero vector and the a hat is equals to be arbitrary. It means that in null vector there is no direction, not certain direction. So this one is called arbitrary, but the magnitude will be zero. That is important, and that is fixed. The magnitude of vector A in null vector will be zero vector, and the direction can be arbitrary. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you that how to obtain a zero vector. Okay, so let me write how to obtain a zero vector. Okay, so when we add, first of all let me write, then I will tell you. So when we add a vector into its negative vector, we obtain a zero vector. Means that when we add a vector into its negative vector, we obtain a zero vector. Or we can take vector A as vector B, C or D or any alphabet. I told you how we can represent the magnitude of any vector, how we can represent the direction of any vector, and how to obtain a zero vector. I've also told you that. Okay, so now it's the turn that I'm going to tell you I'm going to show you bar graph so that you can understand it clearly, the null vector topic. So no need to rub, I'm just rubbing a little bit. So this one is the bar graph. Okay, this one side is x positive. Okay, this one side is y negative. This one is y positive and this one is y negative. Sorry, means x negative. So there are numbers on the number line on the bar graph. So here is 1, 2, 3, 4. Here is also 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the negative there will be -1, -2, -3, -4. I'm just doing it short. So y negatives. Okay, and on this side it will be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. Okay, so I'm going to tell you that the numbers on the number line will go to infinity. They are infinity. We just can't count them, because on the number line numbers are they will go to infinity. And on the same, on the negative side, on the negative x or y positive, x negative, y negative, on the all the number lines numbers are will go to infinity. Now let me tell you that what this mid one is called. This midpoint one is called 0, 0, means that the origin is 0, 0. So why the midpoint is called 0, 0? Because the value of y positive, let's take the value of y positive and x positive, the value of y positive on the number line, the value of x positive on the number line will be same. Means that their both values will be same. That's why it is called 0, 0. And on this and on this side also, and on in, this side also. So that's why it is called 0, 0. So I have shown you the bar graph and too many. And I hope that you will not be confused in the hat symbol or arbitrary. I'm once again telling you that what is arbitrary. Arbitrary, like arbitrary direction means that not certain. Arbitrary means not certain. An arbitrary direction is not certain direction, because in null vector there is no certain direction, but there is always be a magnitude, and the magnitude will be always equal to zero. And the vector quantity has two factors, magnitude plus direction. But in the scalar quantity, only it has magnitude, but no specified direction, not any direction. So this was my today's topic. That was all my today's topic. So thanks for watching, and I know that there are few more types of vectors, but it will be discussed on another videos, like equal vectors, unit vector, and parallel vectors, anti-parallel vectors. So that will be discussed on another videos. Thank you.